Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Today we are going to present the topic classification of crops. First I would like to introduce myself. I am Vijay Kumar Srivastava. I have done my MSc from G.V. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar, with a specialization in agronomy and presently working as a seed professional in one of the MNC. In this presentation we are going to cover the various topics related to crop classifications like crop characteristics, life cycle of crops, seasons, climatic conditions, culture requirements and different important usage. Hope this presentation will be very useful to the candidates who are preparing for various agriculture competitive exams and general competitions. I would like to get feedback from all of you for my further improvements in next coming presentations. So now we will proceed to the presentation.
Here we will discuss the basis of classification. The classification is done to generalize similar crop plants as a class for attaining better understanding of them. The crops are classified in different ways, like classification based on ontogeny, means on basis of life cycle, classification based on economic usage, this is also called based on agronomical classification, seasonal classification, botanical classification, commercial classification, climate-based classification, classification based on range of cultivation, classification according to place of origin, according to important usage and cultural requirements. Classification based on ontogeny means life cycle. First crop is annual crops. The crop plants that complete life cycle within a season or year. They produce seed and die within the season, and such crops are wheat, rice, maize, mustard, etc. Second one is biennial crops. The plants that have lifespan of two consecutive seasons or years. First year, these plants have purely vegetative growth, and in the second year they produce flower, stalks or seeds, and such crops are coming like sugar beet, beetroot, cabbage, radish, carrots, etc. Third one is perennial crops. They live for three or more than 3 years. They may have seed bearing or non-seed bearing capacity, and such crops are coming like Napier fodder grass, coconut. And in general, perennial crops occupy land for more than 30 months. Second one, classification based on economic usage or agronomical classification. In these categories, the crops are coming. First one is cereals. They are cultivated grasses grown for their edible starchy grains. Larger grains used as staple food, which are rice, wheat, maize, barley, oats, etc. The word cereal is derived from the Roman words like Ceres, which denotes a goddess who was believed to be the giver of grains. Second one is millets, a small grain cereal which form the staple food in dry regions of the developing countries. And these are also annual grasses of the group cereals, but they are grown in lesser area, or these are having very less importance and productivity are also less. These are also staple food for people of poor countries. And crops coming in this categories are sorghum, pearl millet, finger millet, foxtail millet, little millet, common millet and other millets. Third one is pulses. Seed of leguminous plant used as food in India, generally called dal, which are rich in protein. Pod containing grains is the economic portion. Pulses are preferred for protein rich value and also economic important in cropping pattern. The wastes or stalks are called hulam or stubber, and these are used for green manure and also as a cattle feed. Green pods used vegetables, that and such crops are cowpea, lovelove and other seed cut of pulses are nutritious cattle feeds. Now we will see, these are oil seed crops. These crops are rich in fatty acids and cultivated for production of vegetable oils. They are used either for edible or industrial or medicinal purpose, like groundnut, peanut, rapeseed and mustard, sesamum, sunflower, castor, linseed or flaxseed, Niger or safflower. Now sugar and starch crops. These crops are cultivated for sugar and starch, like sugar cane, sugar beet, potato, sweet potato, tapioca and asparagus. Next category is fiber crops. These plants are grown for obtaining fiber And these fibers are obtained from different part of crops, like first one is seed fiber, in which a cotton crop is coming, and second one is a fiber which we received from a stem, like jute, mesta, and third one is leaf fiber, means crops which are providing fiber through leaves, means agave and pineapple crops. Now we will discuss about fodder and forage crops. These crops refer to vegetative manner, fresh or preserved, which are utilized for feed for animals. And these crops are like including hay, silage, pastures, and fodder grasses like bajra, fodder bajra, napier grass, guinea grass, fodder sorghum, fodder maize, and under legumes, the crops are coming as lucerne and desmanthus, etc. Now, spices and condiment crops. These crop plants or have products used for flavor, taste, and add color to fresh or preserved foods. And in this category, the crops are ginger, garlic, fenugreek, cumin, turmeric, chilies, onion, coriander, asafoetida, etc. Now, medicinal plants. These crops used for preparation of medicines like lavender, aloe vera, cinnamon, mint, and others. Now, beverages crops. The product of crops used for preparation of mild, agreeable, and stimulating drinkings, like tea, coffee, cocoa, and then plantation crops are coming majorly in this category. After that, narcotics, fumitories, and masticatories. These crops are used for stimulating agents, and these are causing drowsing or having releasing effects. And crops are tobacco, ganja, opium, poppy, etc. Now, seasonal classification. In this category, the crops are divided like first kharif or southwest monsoon season crops. In this category, the crops grown during June, July, and yields up to September, October. These crops required a warm, wet weather during their major period of growth and shorter day length during flowering. And in this group, the crops are coming rice, maize, castor, groundnut, etc. Second one is rabi crops or post-monsoon crops. These crops grown during October, November, and ends till February. And these crops require cold, dry weather for major growth period and longer day length for flowering. And in this category, the crops are wheat, mustard, barley, oats, potato, Bengal gram, barsim, cabbage, and cauliflower. Means these rabi crops are winter season crops. Third one is jayad or summer crops. These crops grown during February, March, and cropping period ends till June. And these crops required warm, dry weather for growth and longer day and long length for flowering also. And this group, the crops are black gram, green gram, sesamum, cowpea, etc. This classification is not a universal one, and it is only indicates the period when a crop is particular crop is raised. Like kharif rice, kharif maize, rabi maize, summer pulse, etc. Now, botanical or taxonomical classification. Here, according to systematic botany, plants are classified as order, family. Botanical or scientific names of plants, which consist of genus and species and are universally accepted. And there is one of the Swedish botanist, Carlos Linnaeus, who was responsible for the botanical system of classification. And in this category, the crops or plants are categorized as Poaceae family, like Gramineae, in which cereals, millets, and grasses are coming. Second one is Papilioniaceae, which belongs to legume crops. And in this family, all pulses, legume fodders, vegetables, groundnuts, barsim, green manures are falling. Cruciferae, in which mustard, Indian rapeseed, radish, cabbage, cauliflower are coming. Cucurbitaceae, which belongs to all gourds, cucumber and pumpkin crops. After this, Malvaceae, fiber crops like cotton, lady's finger, roselle. Then Solanaceae crops, in which the crops are coming potato, tomato, tobacco, chilies, brinjal, etc. Then Tiliaceae, under which jute crop is falling. And then Asteraceae, which is compositae family. In these crops, sunflower, safflower, niger. Then Chenopodiaceae, in which the crops belongs to spinach, sugar beet. Pedilyaceae, sesamum crop. Then Euphorbiaceae, which is covering castor and tapioca. Then Convolvuliaceae, then sweet potato. Then Umbelliferae, which crops covering coriander, cumin, carrot, anise. Then Liliaceae family, like crops coming in this category, onion, garlics. And Gingiberaceae, which are having ginger and turmeric crops. So like this, there are other many families and having different crop categories. Now we will go for commercial classification. In this category, the crop have been classified based on plant products which come into commercial fields. First one is food crops. In this category, the crops are like rice, wheat, green gram, soybean, maize, sorghum, millet, groundnut. Then these part is covering the main edible crops. Second one is fodder and forage crops, which are used for animal feed. And in this category, all fodders, oats, fodder sorghum, fodder maize, napier grass, fodder millets, stilo, and lucerne, etc. coming. Third one is industrial or commercial crops, which refers to the crops like cotton, sugar cane, sugar beet, tobacco, jute, etc. And fourth one is food adjuvants. Food adjuvants are the crops who are related to improving the immune system of the body. And such crops have medicinal value also. And like crops, turmeric, garlic, cumin, alums comes under this category. After that, we will discuss about climate-based classification. And according to this, there are four crops. First one is tropical crops, which are coming under hot climate, tropical climate, and such crops are coconut, sugarcane. Second one is subtropical crop, which are having the medium dry requirement of medium tropical and medium high temperature range. In under this, crops are coming like rice, cotton. Third one is temperate crops, which can be said as winter crop or post monsoon rabi crops. And crops like wheat and barley in this group. After that, polar crops. The polar crops mean the crops which are grown in extreme low temperature conditions. And in this group, the crops are coming all pine crops, pasture grasses. Now classification according to range of cultivation. And in this basis, the crops are categorized in four crops. First one is garden crop. The crops grown on a small scale in garden, like onion, brinjals, garlic, turmeric, etc. Second one is plantation crops. These crops are grown on a large scale in estates. And these crops are perennial in nature, means grown continue for longer years, like more than 3 years. And such crops are coming tea, coffee, cocoa, rubber, etc. And third one is field crops. These are the crops we are having the major under agriculture cultivations, and these are grown on vast scale under field conditions, and they are mostly seasonal, such as rice, wheat, cotton, etc., and used for as a edible fodder and other purposes. Now classification according to place of origin. In this classification, the crops are categorized in two types. First one is native crops. The crops grown within the geographical limits of their origin, like rice, barley, black gram, green gram, mustard, castor, sugarcane, and cotton grown in India and are native to India. And second one is exotic or introduced crops. Means these crops are introduced from other countries, like tobacco, potato, jute, maize, apple, etc. Now crop classification according to important usage. First one is catch crops. These are also called contingent crops. These are the crops cultivated to catch the forthcoming season. It replaces the main crop that has been failed due to abiotic, biotic, or management hazards. Generally, they are of very short duration, quick growing, quick harvestable, or usable at any times of their field duration and adaptable to the season, soil, and management practices. These crops are providing feed, and they are preventing weeds growth, they conserve soil and utilize added fertilizer and moisture. And crops under this categories are coming green gram, black gram, cowpea, onion, coriander, bajra, etc. Second one is restorative crops. These are the crops which provide a good yield along with enrichment or restoration of soil fertility or amelioration of the soils. Amelioration refers to the improvement in soil. They fix atmospheric nitrogen in root nodules, shed their leaves during ripening, and thus restore soil conditions and improve fertility. And crops coming in restorative categories are legumes, because these are having the nitrogen fixation capacity and properties of green manuring crops also. Third one is exhaustive crops. These are the crops which on growing leave the field exhausted because of a more aggressive nature, like gingerly, brinjal, linseed, sunflower. Means these crops are utilizing more nutrients from the soil, and why? Because of this, the soils is become weak and deficient in nutrition. So these are called exhaustive crops. Fourth one is paracrop or residual crops. These are those crops plant which are sown a few days or weeks before the harvest of the standing mature crop to utilize the residual moisture without preparatory tillage. Means these are crops, these crops are sown before harvesting of standing crops. The standing crops and the later sown para crop become simultaneous and with a pair for a short period, and like rice fallow pulses with black gram, lathyrus, lentil, etc. Para crop in succession may constitute relay cropping. This means if we are growing together, it may be result to relay cropping. After that, smother crops. These are the crop plants which are able to smother or suppress weed growth by providing suffocation, checking movement of air, and obscuration of the incidental radiation through their dense foliage develops due to quick growing ability and heavy trailing or branching, planophilic or procurement or trailing habits. These crops are coming in these category, the crops are coming barley, mustard, and cowpea. Means these are the crops which are preventing the growth of weeds by its profuse growth, and they are suppressing the weeds. After that, cover crops. These are the crops which are able to protect the soil surface from erosion, like wind erosion, water erosion, and both. And these crops are having the capacity to cover the ground with their foliage and or root mats. And crops coming in this categories are groundnut, black gram, marble grass, sweet potato. Means they are full on the upper layer of the surface, they are covering the ground, so there will be less chances of any type of erosions. After that, nurse crop, a companion crop which nourishes the main crop by way of nitrogen fixation or adding the organic matter into the soil, like cowpea intercropped with cereals, Glycyrrhiza, Tephrosia in tea. Means they are the crops, when they are grown with main crop, they will provide the nitrogen fixation to the standing crop. After that, guard or barrier crops. These are the crop plants which help to protect another crop from trespassing or restrict the speed of wind, and thus prevent crop damage. Main crop in center surrounded by hardy or thorny crops, like mesta around sugarcane, sorghum around cotton, safflower around grams. Means these are the crops which are protecting the main crop which are in center, and these barrier crops are on the border side, and they will face the any type of hazards. After that, trap crops. These are the crop plants grown to trap soil borne harmful parasitic weeds, like orobanke and striga are trapped by solanaceous crops and sorghum crops respectively. Means orobanke weeds growth will be parasite which growth will be suppressed by solanaceous crop, and striga in sorghum crops. Nematodes are trapped by solanaceous crops, and castor works as a trap crop in cotton if grown with cotton groundnut, and this will prevent the crop from armyworm pest. After that, augmenting crops. These are the crops which are sown to supplement the yield of the main crop. It means these crops will provide the nutrification supplements of nutrient to the main crop, like mustard or cabbage. If grown with barsim, these will work as a augment crop for the increasing forage yield of barsim. After that, alley crops. These are the arable crops which are grown in alleys formed by trees or shrubs, established mainly to hasten soil fertility restoration, enhance soil productivity, and reduce soil erosion and diversify farm income. Means alley cropping is a planting rows of tree at wide spacing with a companion crop grown in the alley wedge between the rows. Means there, if we are growing the crops, these crops are grown in between rows of trees, and these crops will prevent the soil fertility and this nutrient capacity, protect from soil erosion, etc. And these alley crops are generally non-trailing with shade tolerance. These are having the shade tolerance capacity, and the crops coming in this category are pulses, which are grown with casuarina trees. Now, classification according to cultural requirement of crops. In this category, the crops are divided on different parameters, like first one, according to suitability of topo sequence. First one is crop under upland. These are labeled elevated lands with drain all around, or unbounded labeled lands with drain or drops. Crops cannot tolerate water stagnation comes under this group, like red grams, groundnut, maize, sorghum, cotton, napier, etc. There are also some crops which require sufficient soil moisture but cannot tolerate water stagnation, water logging. And such crops are potato, sugarcane, upland rice, ragi, wheat, black gram, Bengal gram, etc. Second crop based on topo sequence is crops grown on lowland. These lands are provided with dikes or bunds all around to a stagnant water. Crops that require abundant supply of water and can withstand prolonged waterlogged conditions like rice, dhecha, paragrass, and jutes. Now, second category is according to source of water. The first one is irrigated crops. The crops cultivation primarily depends on the irrigation water for a part or entire crop growth of the crop. All crops respective seasons are possible to be raised in this category because irrigated water is available for throughout the life cycle. After that, rain-fed crop. The crop cultivation entirely depends on the rainfall received. Crop varieties depend on the season and the rainfall pattern. If there is no sufficient rainfall, there may be chances of failure of crops. Now, the crops classification according to moisture availability in the soil. The first one, wetland crops. In these crops, the soil moisture is allowed to occupy both macro and microspores. Anaerobic field conditions prevails here. Anaerobic means the less presence of oxygen in soil environment. In such fields, the crops suitable are tolerant to water stagnation, like green manure, Sesbania group, and grasses. After that, dryland crops. The soil moisture is allowed only onto the microspores. Microspores are filled with air. In such crops, the microspores are having the soil moisture, and microspores are having aeration. Magnitude of soil moisture varies according to the crop. Crops like maize highly sensitive to excess moisture and drought. There are some crops which are tolerant to drought and temporary stagnation. Sorghum are cultivated in this type of field condition. Now, crop classification based on sustainability of the texture group of soils, like crops suitable to sandy loam soils. In this category, the crops are coming sorghum, bajra, green gram, sunflower, potato, onion, carrots. And second, crops suitable to silty loam medium soils, like jute, sugarcane, maize, cotton, mustard, tobacco, Bengal gram, and red gram crops. And there are some crops which are suiting to clay loam heavy soils, like rice, wheat, barley, linseed, lentil, paragrasses, guinea grasses, and marvel grasses, etc. Now, classification according to tolerance to the problem soils. There are some crops which are tolerant to acidic soils, like wetland rice, potato, mustard crop. Some crops are tolerant to saline soils, like chilies, cucurbits, wheat, sorghum, etc. There are some crops which are tolerant to alkali and sodic nature soils, like barley, cotton, Bengal gram, barsim, sunflower, maize. Some crops are tolerant to waterlogged condition, like wetland rice, dhecha, paragrass, napier grass, guinea grass, etc. And there are some crops which are tolerant to soil erosion, means marble grass, groundnut, black gram, rice bean, moth bean, and horse gram. Means these crops roots are strongly catching the soil particles and they are preventing from soil erosion. After that, this crop classification according to tillage requirement. First one is arable crops. These crops required preparatory tillage, means soil preparation activities, plowing, leveling, etc. And such crops are potato, tobacco, rice, maize. And there are some crops, non-arable crops, which may not require preparatory cultivation or tillage operations, like paragrasses. After that, classify crops according to depth of root system. There are some crops having shallow root crops, like rice, potato, onion. Crops having moderately deep rooted, like wheat, groundnut, castor, tobacco. Some crops are deep rooted, means covering the roots are going up to deep level of the soil, and like this maize, cotton, and sorghum. And there are some crops having very deep rooted, like sugarcane, safflower, lucerne, and red gram. And crop classification according to tolerance to hazards weather conditions, like frost tolerant crops. These crops can easily tolerate frost conditions during winter season, like sugar beet, beetroot. And there are some cold tolerant crops which can bear the low temperatures, like potato, cabbage, mustards. These are winter season crops, rabi crops. After that, drought tolerant. These crops can tolerate high temperatures, and these are tropical crops grown in kharif season, like bajra, jowar, barley, safflower, castor, etc. There are some crops classification according to method of sowing or planting, like direct seeded crops, where the seeds are sown directly in the field, like upland rice, wheat, jowar, bajra, groundnut. And there are some planted crops where the plant parts are planted directly, like sugarcane, potato, sweet potato, napier, guinea grass. In these crops, we are not using seed, but plant parts we are using. After that, transplanted crops, where seedlings are raised in the nursery, pulled out, and after that, transplanted in the main field, like rice, ragi, bajra, tobacco, onion, brinjals, etc. Now, crop classification according to inter-tillage requirement, especially earthing up. These crops needs intercultural operation, mainly earthing up for their good crop stands. The first one is inter-tilled crops. In these crops which require earthing up compulsorily, these are potato, sweet potato, groundnut, maize, sugarcane, and turmeric for better establishment. And second was non-inter-tilled crops, means there is no need of tillage requirement. And such crops are fodder sorghum, dinanath grass, paragrass, etc. And there are some crop classification according to their field duration. In this, first one is very short duration crops, which are having the age up to 75 days, crops coming pulses. And there are some short duration crops having the age between 75 to 100 days. And these crops are sunflower, cauliflower, upland rice, etc. There are medium duration crops, 100 to 125 days, like wheat, jowar, bajra, groundnut, sesamum, etc. There are some long duration crops, like covering 125 to 125 days to maturity, like mustard, tobacco, cotton. And very long duration crops, which required more than 150 days, and like these sugarcane, red gram, castor, etc. There are some crops related to method of harvesting, like some crops needs reaping in rice wheat, some uprooting by pulling, like Bengal gram, black gram, which we are pulling out directly from the field. Some harvesting method uprooting by digging, means by mechanical methods we are doing, like potato, sweet potato, groundnut, etc. Picking, where we are harvesting is done by means of picking from the direct plant, like in cotton, fiber picking, in vegetables, fruit picking. And like priming, where in priming is followed in tobacco. Priming refers to the picking up, means harvesting of leaves from plant in case of tobacco. And after that cutting, we are cutting the plant from bottom, like Bursum, Napier grasses. Grazing means in this field directly we are not harvesting, directly we are leaving the animals and for grazing. After that classification according to post harvest requirement, like some crops needs curing. Like in curing means drying off leaves in directly in the field, like in case of tobacco. And in case of mustard, we are harvesting and drying the plant parts till full maturity. After that striping. Striping means removal of fiber material from jute, and they are dried in the field, like jute and sun hemp. After that selling, followed in groundnut. After that ginning operations in cotton. Means ginning refers to the removal of this cotton lint and seed separation both. After that seasoning means after harvesting of the crops they are drying in the field till it's come to the correct stage. After that grafting and sorting, grading and sorting. In this case after harvesting we are making sorting according to their sizes and a cleaning process, like potato, rice, wheat and fiber crops. After that crops classification based on growing soil condition, like crops grown on semophytes, means which are grown in sandy soils. Some crops are lithophytes, which are grown on rock surfaces, ferns. Chasmophytes, which are grown on rock carex, like potato. Acidophytes, the crops which can be grown on acidic soils, like potato. Basophytes, that means the crop can be grown in alkali soils like rice. Calcifites means which the crops can be grown in basic soils like asparagus. And halophytes, crop in saline soils like sugar beet, alfalfa, etc. So these are all about the classification of crops based on different properties. Hope this presentation will be very very useful to all. Thank you very much for your kind attention. I have presented here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava, and contents published here. So request to please go through and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.